Hey guys, Murloc68 here. Hope everybody's doing well. This beautiful brass 334B45 Lockwood Asa Abloy was sent to me by my good friend, the Aussie dissector, Paul Springett. Now, I featured this lock way back in video number 99, and yesterday kind of came across it on this bench while I was in search for something else that clearly I didn't find. And I remembered that this lock was a 5-pinner when I opened it up in video number 99. And I decided last night to open it up, and I filled that 6th chamber. I didn't make any major changes, but I had trouble picking this one. It was a 5-pinner. Those beautiful, beautiful spools that they had, those sharp spools. So I added the 6th pin and changed up the drivers just a little bit. I didn't do any threading or anything like that, and I wanted to see if I could pick it again. So here we go. Just a beautiful, beautiful lock. Boron steel. That's the toughest you're gonna get for a shackle. So let's see what we got here. Alright, let's give it a shot, see what we can do today. Yeah, I had a tough time picking this lock anyway. Okay, small click out of 1 and 2. Click there. Just using light tension. And of course, this is the first attempt since I put the new pins in last night. Just a beautiful lock. Counter rotation on 5. There's a click. Come back up front here. Okay, 2 gave me a false set. Actually, a false set back that I had lost. Let's check pin 6. Okay, a click. Okay, so a little bit of movement there on pin 2. 3 is binding. stick stuck there. And that didn't go so well. Okay. Click out a four there, but I think I overset somebody. Back up one. Three, four, okay. Okay, five. Give me counter rotation. See where I'm at here. Okay, I think that was six, five. Pretty deep fault set. Let me check pin one without losing this tension. I think that was five set. Mm-hmm. and four. That was two. Exactly like I remember it. Thank you. thought of leave well enough alone or watch what you wish for comes to mind right about now. That was 4. Got the tension fairly light. Just keep dancing in and out of these fault sets, which is what makes the lock so intriguing. Surprise, struggling a bit with this. Is not a surprise. Not a surprise. Come on, you bastard. I'm gonna try this one on the kiwi. Five, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that can't be. Have to reset it. I'm really in a battle now. Okay. Got my deep fault set. Counter rotation on 4. I don't think I got everything there. Four still bound. Okay. 1. two, okay, three. Problems with my hands lately. Okay, so I've overset. I had to let off drop. I need to see if I can reposition my pick and get underneath that pin. I think it's pin number 6. And I'm not going to get in there this way. Gonna get in there with this hook. Well, maybe. Yeah. Fucking maybe doesn't work in this business. Okay, I'm gonna pull this out of it. This gives me that room. This feather light on the tension. Okay, coming under 5. Still can't get it. Ugh, son of a bitch. Make some room to get my pick underneath. Let's see if I can set pin 6 again. That's dropped. Okay, click 5. Was 4. Trying to precisely get on pin 3, but I keep slipping off. 1, 2. Okay, there's 3. That is close. That is close. I can't figure out why. Very gently trying to get underneath each pin. I know I fucked up somewhere. Problem is, if you don't watch that frickin' warning. Oh boy. Dancing with the fucking devil here. Fucking lost everything. stumped. Just change a couple pins, add that sixth pin. Boy, impressed with myself at all here. Look at that. Fucking trapped myself right in that fucking warding and I twisted it back. How many fucking times have I done that? Feel this thing out here. Now we gotta get down to the brass tacks. Pardon the pun. Just going nowhere here. Can't figure out why. just going around in circles here. Literally. I keep switching positions on the lock because my hand is really messed up. So just to give me a different comfort from another angle temporarily. Bastard. Fuck. This video is gonna go right in the garbage. Yeah. Unfortunately, it has to be posted the way it is, guys. It has to be posted the way it is, because if I start changing that, then it's not my channel. This thing. Look at that. Just fucking with me. I just fucked it up there. So you want to add a sixth fucking pin and try to pick it yourself, do you? How many times have you fucking done this? Just fucking teetering. Shameful at best. This is a kind of lock that separates you from fucking elite pickers. Now everything is overset. Thank you. No check pin one. Maybe I should have done that 45 minutes ago. Six. See, when frustration starts to set in like it is right now, you got two choices. Quit. Just take a second. Recompose yourself. And just remember what we're here for. You're here for the open. At all costs. I just can't get around figuring it out. It's all up to you how you want to handle it. I'm not happy, but job done. I'm going to learn a couple of things. Tension, man. That's it. Plain and simple. And after picking over 500 plus locks on camera, don't for a second kid yourself that you're exempt from a school day at the Lockwood Assa Abloy Foundation. What's even funnier, if you guys are still here, I'll continue talking. I was looking in this mess for a key that I've lost. Well, it's not lost, it's here. The excavator's on its way. It's $300 an hour, so I figure 6 hours. They should be able to dig it out So anyways, looking for this key, I came across this in the back. So there you go, guys. It's 6 pins. Should have fucking left it alone. Okay. Everything, as you can see, had to be picked. They're all standard key pins. And, yeah, so looking for that key. It's fucking tapered key pins, eh? I came across this guy and I said, geez, I wonder when the hell I picked this. So I looked back. It was video number 99. And I was looking at the key and I said, wow, this is a 5-pinner. Like, I couldn't remember, so I opened it up. By the way, I had a difficult time finding a... But I did find a pin for position 6. It's a fairly long pin. Anyway, nothing done here. This is where I did all my changes. Oh, fuck. What a way to start. That just flew out. Got an ASA alloy in 2. Now I'm going to have to get up and search for that. Shit. Spool in 3. Spool in 4. I can't get the spring out. Okay, it's a commercial spool in 5. Okay, that came out of 6. Let's see if I can get the rest of these springs out. Guys, bear with me for a second. I've located the missing spool out of position 1. So I put a heavier spring, not a bit lighter spring, in position 6. So I went with the original spool in 1. An ASA pin in 2, original spool in 3, original spool in 4, commercial spool in 5, and what did I do here? And another spool in 6. So I'll show it to you like that. That's the 6 spinner. I'll take pictures for you guys. There's the key. It's a pretty nasty key. So pin number 6 rolled off the tip of that key. And it came down pretty low. So guys, thanks for sticking by if you did. The ASA Abloy 334B that I did in video number 99. Some changes. I added the 6th pin and switched up a few of the pins. And I got killed. But we got it open. Thanks for your support, guys. Patience, practice, perseverance. I'm going to post it as is, because that's the way it went. Take care. Appreciate your support.